Good afternoon, everybody. Brother Lloyd here. Shabbat shalom to all my Sabbath keepers out there. I hope you're all having a wonderful, blessed, peaceful, safe day. Now, today I'm going to do a request video in which someone asked me if I would do a video about all the holidays. But I'm going to just take it one step at a time. And since Christmas is right around the corner, I'm going to talk about the tree. Not the whole holiday, just the tree. Because a lot of Christmas is centered on the tree. And the other part is centered on that jolly old soul called Saint Nick. Well, if you scramble the letters up, Satan. And really, that's what it's all about. So, if you're sensitive to hearing the truth, you have to do with it what you will. But some people have asked, and some people want to know the truth, and some people risk coming away from the false truth. Because the problem is, when you come away from things like Christmas and all these other holidays, you come up against it through your family members, friends, co-workers, whomever, because they don't understand or don't want to understand, and a lot of times it's spun as if we're being fanatics and rebellious and all these things because we want to come away from all these idolatrous, paganistic rooted things. And the Father's Word tells us to do so. So, as you come away from them, you have to, quote-unquote, suffer the consequences of man's wrath sometimes to deal with and do what the Father tells us to do accordingly. So, here we go. Jeremiah 10:2, which reads, "Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them." We're hearing already in Jeremiah 10:2, the Father is telling us what not to do. He said, don't get caught up in their ways, in their customs, in their traditions, and all these things. Leviticus 18:3 and Ezekiel 27, which are references from that, reemphasize this point. It points out, it says, the Egyptian, the Canaanites, it says, their ordinances, their customs, their traditions, cast away and do not defile yourselves with their idols and all these other things. The Father is very clear. He doesn't want us to learn the ways that are against Him. This is what happened to the children of Israel when they were in captivity for all those years. They picked up a whole lot of ways from the Egyptians. Also, keep this in mind. It's very important. It says, be not dismayed, which means don't be horrified, shocked, appalled, distressed, or what have you. Don't be dismayed at the signs of heaven. Well, why? When it comes to the stars and the constellations of heaven, the Almighty Himself has forbidden His people, us, to give credit or fear to the constellations and the conjunctions of stars and planets because they have no power of themselves. Because they, just like everything on this planet, everything is in heaven, is governed by Him. And their secret motions and influences are not known to man, and therefore there can be no certain judgment thereof by men. We have to understand that the heavens, the stars, all that stuff is His. So don't get caught up in all these things, religious or otherwise, that focus on what the Father says is His. For His to know and not for ours. So when it comes to all these astrology-based things and sciences and religions that focus on the stars and moons and all that, the Father says, stay away from that. That's His. Those are His secrets, not ours. The Egyptians and the Greeks created many gods and worshiped many things based on heavens and the stars, and they're all false. The Word says these are the Father's secrets. They're not for man to know, any man. So, don't look into His secret things. Deuteronomy 29:29 tells us, the secret things belong to the Lord our God, but the things revealed belong unto us. The things revealed belong unto us. Whatever He reveals to us belongs to us. If He doesn't reveal it to us, it's not ours. And to our children forever, that we may do all the words of His law. Not man's law, not any man's law, His law. So, the Father gives us what we need to know, but we have to stop digging and digging into a lot of things that keep us distracted from focusing on the important things that will get us to reach the ultimate goal. And the enemy doesn't want us to do that, so he likes to distract us with all these things that don't matter. And like I said, during the captivity, the children of Israel learned a lot of things that their father tried to wean them off of for 40 years roaming around in the wilderness, because they brought that stuff out of Egypt and Canaan and everywhere else. They brought it hot and heavy, and it was so much a part of them. That's part of what caused them to be so rebellious and hard-headed and all those things that they were doing when they were in the wilderness, because they were caught up. So the father had them wander and wander, walking in circles for 40 years trying to wean them off of that stuff, because he did not want that stuff going into the land that he had promised them. And the land that he had promised them had some of the same things going on in it. So he had to make sure that they were good, so when they got in there, that they would disregard all that same old mess from the Canaanites and everybody else. Now, Jeremiah 10:3 reads, it says, "For the customs of the people are vain." Now, what's that mean? Vanity. Having or showing excessive high opinions of one's appearance, abilities, or worth. Producing no result. Worthless or useless. It's vain. All these things are in vain. This was in reference to what? Their statutes and their ordinances and all these idolatrous things that they were doing. Next part. "For one cutteth the tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workmen, with an axe." Sounds like a lumberjack to me. It's very clear. Scripture is very clear. It says you go in there and you chop a tree down with your hands. Isaiah 40:19 tells us this in reference to the tree being cut out of the forest. It reads, "The workman melteth a graven image, and the goldsmith spreadeth it over with gold and casteth silver chains." Sounds like a tree in your house when you're putting all these silver ornaments and all this stuff on there. See, this is where this stuff comes from. It's so common, and it's been so common for so long, so many thousands of years, that it's exactly what people are doing today, and you can't mistake it for anything else. Isaiah 45:20 reads, "Assemble yourselves and come, draw near together, ye that are escaped of nations." So it's saying those of us who have come away from this, escape that. Escape away from all the people who do all this stuff. "They have no knowledge that set up the wood of their graven image and pray unto a God that cannot save." See, it says come away from those people and that stuff. It says they have no knowledge and they pray unto a God that cannot save. So when you set these trees up in your home, you're setting up an idol. You're setting up a graven wooden image, idol, what have you. And it's a god. And everyone worships their trees in their home. In fact, you can see some people really getting caught up with their trees. Isaiah 46:7 reads, "They bear him upon the shoulder, they carry him, and set him in his place, and he standeth. From his place shall he not remove, yea, one shall cry upon him, yet can he not answer, nor save him out of his trouble." See, people, these things we do out of custom and traditions the Father has already spoken on, because they were issues when they started out thousands and hundreds of years ago. They were issues then, and He spoke about it then. And we have it written from thousands of years ago. All we have to do is read it. It tells us what to do and what not to do. These things are only ways to forsake our Father and worship false gods and idols, whether we accept it or not. This is what it's all about. Look, people, here's a note of warning. Once you know the truth, you are held accountable. The Father holds us accountable for going against His word, rejecting His word, denying His word, etc. Whether we read this or not, it's the truth, and we're held accountable. So you can't deny it and say, "Oh, I didn't know," because you didn't read it. If you choose not to study the law and remain ignorant of it, the consequences are on us if we find ourselves in a situation that puts us under the law. Jeremiah 10:4 reads, "They deck it with silver and with gold. They fasten it with nails and with hammers, that it move not." But not today. We have these nice stands of all sorts that we just mount it in there. But see, back in the day, they used to nail it. Same thing. Same tree, same thing. Jeremiah 10:5. "They are upright as a palm tree, but speak not." Why don't they speak? Because false gods cannot speak. They must needs be born, because they cannot go. "Be not afraid of them, for they cannot do evil, neither also is it in them to do good." Now, here's a breakdown of what this means according to the Father's word in reference to idols. And the tree is inclusive because most of the idols were made out of wood, and most of them still are today. But you have other different materials that they're made out of. But still, we're talking about wood, we're talking about the tree. Psalms 115, 5 through 8 reads like this. "They have mouths, but they speak not. Eyes have they, but they see not. They have ears, but they hear not. Noses have they, but they smell not. They have hands, but they handle not. Feet they have, but they walk not. Neither speak through their throat." Verse 8. "They that make them are like unto them, so is everyone that trusteth in him." Once again, people, the Father tells us that he is serious about worshiping and idolizing that which he forbids. It's up to us to decide whether we will come away from customs and traditions of man perpetrated by the enemy to get us to dishonor the word of the Father and the Father himself. But like I said, it's so entrenched in most of us that we won't, because we don't want to disappoint people, children, whomever. But keep in mind that the Father's people are to be different from everyone else. That's how he can tell us apart from the tares. Remember the wheat and the tares? He has to be able to tell them apart. So he wants us to be different. He wants us to do specific things. He wants us to follow specific laws and ordinances and whatever. He wants us to be different from the rest of the world. We can't keep trying to be like the world, to be part of it, and then claim that we're his. Christmas is no different than so many other holidays and celebrations. They are all of man and rooted in the same types of idolatry and false worships. Even the stocking on the chimney, mistletoe, yule logs, candles in the windows, etc., etc., etc. They all individually have their own roots. Birthdays, candles, cakes, all that stuff. The wickedness behind most of these things still don't deter most people from celebrating them, because we disguise it to make it appear beautiful and fun. But I challenge some of you to this. Read Isaiah 44, 9 through 20. And it gives you a detailed account of what idols are all about in another perspective. If you read it, let me know. Well, let me know what you think about it. But keep in mind, the tree is nothing but a sign that the enemy has you worshiping something that is a false idol. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.